Welcome to Sales Data. In this video, I'm going to be giving you a quick tour of the market share report, showing you how you can select criteria to develop custom reports, and then giving you a preview of what the results page will look like. So here we are at the Sales Data homepage, and to get to a market share report, you can navigate over here in the sidebar. It's the fifth report down from the top. A market share report can be useful because it shows you the percentage sales for publishers, distributors, imprints, subjects, and formats in the all markets aggregate. So this is a great way to see your share of the all market as a publisher or distributor, or to get a look at how you stack up against your competitors. For the market share report, there are four options you can base the search criteria on. These correspond to the tabs that are running across the top here, so you can see the market share based on publisher, distributor, subject, or format. To select one of these for your report, you can select the appropriate tab and then fill out the criteria on that page. The first box in all four tabs, so this one here, will change based on which you select, but the remainder of the fields for the comparison are going to stay the same. So here we are on publisher, and with the publisher market share, you can see how different publishers performed over selected subjects, or how they performed over time. Publisher is the default tab whenever you open the market share page. Before running the report, you must specify which publishers you would like to see in the report in the provided text box, or you can stick with this and just check off the top 500 publishers. But if there was something in particular that I was interested in seeing, I can turn this off and start typing the names of publishers in here. So let's say I was interested in seeing Hachette. I can add that in. And I also want to see House of Anansi. And I can keep adding publishers in a similar way. With the distributor tab, it works in a similar way. I can either select which distributors I would like to see by entering them in the provided text box, or I can check off the top 500 distributors tab. Subject is a little bit different. By default, you're going to have the top six categories available here, but if you wanted to, you can click on Add Edit Subjects. This will open a BISAC subject tree, and then you can drill down to get more specific about which subjects you'd like to see. Format works similarly, with the top three levels automatically selected, but of course, you can go into this drop-down tree and then select from there if there's something more specific you're looking for. So going back to the distributor page, you have the option to choose how you would like to compare the data. This is available for the publisher and distributor tabs, but not subject and format. So if I select format, it's then going to prompt me to choose specific binding formats I want to see. Subjects is similar, or we can go with over time. This allows you to modify the reporting period, so you can see a snapshot, which will show you preset columns for the current week, previous week, year to date, the previous year, and the year before last. Consecutive weeks, months, and quarters allows you to choose reporting intervals to appear in the columns. Year over year allows you to see the same reporting interval over the past 10 years. Each year's data is displayed in a separate column, and here again you can choose to see data from the same month, quarter, or year, and it's going to show you data points at that specific moment in time as the years go by. Next, you need to choose how you'd like to rank your results. So you can do that either by units sold or by the total value sold. So that's everything on the criteria selection page. Let's go ahead and run this report and see what the results page looks like. Here we are, and one of the first things that you see when you get to this page is a summary of the parameters that we've used to create this report. So this gives you a reminder of what filters and criteria you're using to view this data. If you wish to change anything on the report, you can click on the View Adjust Criteria button here, and this will take you back to the criteria selection page, and you can modify your parameters from there. So since we selected to view distributor market shares for June year over year, you can see we have the information starting for June 2019, 2018, 2016, and so on and so forth. Your market share reports will automatically be sorted in descending order by rank. Clicking on any of these column titles will resort the data. You can also select this one, the publisher, distributor, format, or subject column, to view your report in alphabetical order. It's worth noting here that while we have a box covering the data, when you're actually in Sales Data, you'll be able to view it. This is just for confidentiality purposes. The data in Sales Data is private and only accessible to Sales Data users. If you don't currently have access to Sales Data and you're interested in the service, you can follow the web link to get in touch with us. Let's say you only wanted to see the percentage of the market share year over year and you weren't interested in the value or units sold. You could click on the Customize Columns button here, and this will allow you to deselect those columns, and they will no longer appear in your report. You also have the option to save the columns that you have currently set in your report and use those as the defaults for any market share reports that you'll be running in the future. As with the other reports in SalesData, you have the option to download or email the report as an Excel or CSV file, or you can save the report to the My Report section of the site over here, or distribute it to your colleagues. Using this option means that every week when the data in SalesData gets updated, this report will regenerate with that new data that we have. So that's everything for the market share report. If you have any questions or interested in learning more about the SalesData reports, you can check out some of our help documentation at this link. And of course, you're welcome to get in touch with us either by using the contact form here or by sending us an email at salesdata@booknetcanada.ca.